Hello and welcome to today's Nairobi News Bulletin. My name is Modoni Mushiri. A strange love affair in Shitirira village in Kakamega has seen two men exchanging spouses. 42-year-old Ernest Anjeche and 25-year-old Patrick Mangala swapped spouses after discovering Mangala was having an affair with Anjeche's wife.
An unusual love story, bizarre and unheard of, that has left residents of Shitirira village in utter shock. Hard to believe until you hear it from the horse's mouth.
Mimi kasaini ya kasaini ya agreement ya kusema nichukue bibi yake na mimi nichukue na yeye achukue bibi yangu tuishi kwa amani na tukasalimiana tukatoka huko kama tumesalimiana tumefurahi tu tukikuja hata nilisindikiza paka hapa.
It all started in April this year when 42-year-old Anjeche, a night guard, discovered his wife was having an affair with a 25-year-old bodaboda operator, Mangala. Anjeche's wife would leave the house every night to meet with Mangala. Mangala's wife, who now lives with Anjeche, attests that her husband was never in the house at night.
Bwanangu alikuwa anatoka asubuhi akienda kazi, atarudi kesho yake asubuhi. Nikimuuliza unatoka wapi ananiambia tunatoka kazi.
When Anjeche confronted Mangala, he denied the accusations. However, a phone Anjeche had bought his wife, which was in Mangala's possession, sold him out. Susan, out of anger, left her matrimonial home and her young husband Mangala. She went to Anjeche's home. An agreement was then made at the village elder's place, but 2 weeks later, Anjeche's wife left Mangala and went back to her parents' home. And now Mangala wants his wife, Susan, back. He has threatened Anjeche with death if he doesn't hand back his wife. On a note he wrote to Anjeche, he says, in quote, "Uko na wangu na mimi sina wako, utarudisha wangu upende usipende," meaning, "You have mine, but I don't have yours. You will return mine whether you like it or not." He further threatened to kill Anjeche if he doesn't comply. Anjeche has since reported the matter to police, but according to him,
huyu amekataa, amesema hawezi toka hapa, atakaa tu hapa. Na mimi nikasema sawa sawa, huyu akikuja, huyo pia akikuja, nakubali kukaa hapa pia atakaa.
The fifth edition of Masaku Sevens has received a boost with the Nation Media Group supporting the tournament to the tune of 15 million shillings. The tournament, scheduled for between the 8th and 10th of July at the Kenyatta Stadium, Machakos, will have teams from schools, universities and local teams.
And you guys should become serious and want to take a picture. I don't want to see that.
This partnership is in line with our commitment to promote local sport and the growth of local talent in the sporting area and arena.
It shows a great commitment, not only of the Machakos County, but other counties in terms of nurturing local talent and sports in the different counties.
This tournament has done a lot for Kenya Rugby. It has raised younger boys who are now international team.
I want to assure the nation, the country, that Masaku Sevens is going to be very well organized.
Fresh details have emerged on how retired ICC prosecutor Louis Morengo Ocampo attempted to lure former police commissioner Major General Hussein Ali as a prosecution witness against President Uhuru Kenyatta. The revelation was first made in a New York Times piece published on Wednesday. General Ali's lawyer, Evans Monari, confirmed the overtures, saying that they flatly turned the offer down. Kabete MP Ferdinand Waititu says he failed to honor an invitation for lunch by court leader Raila Odinga because he does not trust him and his colleagues from the opposition. Mr. Waititu confirmed that he had been invited for the lunch but declined the offer and, as I quote, "I do not trust them at all. I feared he would have our lunch and then they will change tune while addressing the press," end of quote. And finally, former Lugari MP Cyrus Jirongo has sensationally claimed that gunmen who killed an American teacher in the presence of his daughter in Nairobi might have been sent by his political enemies. The American teacher, Mr. Cameron Chase Huntley, was shot dead earlier this month in Lavington by gunmen while on a motorbike and walking to a restaurant with his girlfriend Sally Jirongo for breakfast. And that's it for us for today. For these and more stories, log on to www.nairobinews.co.ke. I'm Modoni Mushiri. Goodbye.